The tone here is mysterious and frightening, and that's achieved through a combination of the diction, the word choice, and the details, the images that Lengel uses here. So first, let's take a look at that word choice. Words like haunted, shadows, bare, sinister, thumped, something, and creaked. And there are a number of words here that are unclear, they're imprecise. The idea of something, thumped, shadows. There's this sense of mystery there. But more than that, those words such as haunted and sinister and creaked certainly add to this frightening feeling. It's not just that it's unknown and possibly a wonderful surprise party, but these other words let us know that we should be frightened or that the narrator is frightened. Moreover, notice the use of imagery, the details that she chooses to share with the reader. Clumps of elves, half in the shadows, blank windows, unhinged shutters. Now, these four all have in common the idea that something is missing. It's not whole, and that can be a little bit disturbing. Then let's look at these other two that describe the colors. Yellow with damp leaves and greenish cast. These are slightly sinister images that are created in the reader's mind and certainly indicate that the narrator, if he's noticing all these details and he's describing them that way, is frightened of the mystery that he or she is about to face.